Well, good morning. Today is October 1st, 2010. My name is Josh Pitka. Welcome to my video blog. Today, I wanted to talk about just basically seed time and harvest time, and what does that mean. I want to encourage you today as well. The basic message I really felt in my heart was just to encourage you to do something for God today. Do something, whether it's planting a seed, whether it's watering a seed. I wanted to read a scripture in just a moment. And allowing God to give increase through your life. Sometimes I like to take kind of inspection and take inventory of my life and say, what have I done? What have I done in this last 9 months? How have I brought forth the kingdom of God? The reality is that a lot of believers don't take inventory. The Bible says, check yourself out and see if you are really in the faith. There is a form of godliness that denies the power of God, and that's called religion. And then there is a true godliness that brings forth fruit. Jesus said 30, 60, or 100-fold. So there's a power in living for Jesus. That's what we want to be about. We want to tap into. We want to encourage the whole body of Christ to rise up and be the body of Christ that we're called to be. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22 says this: this is actually the Lord speaking after the flood. As long as the earth remains, there will be planting and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night. So God is saying, I believe, both in the natural and in the spiritual, that as long as the earth remains, that there will be planting and harvesting. You know, the reality is that lives are changed through process. A lot of times I've heard certain things in the church like, well, one day God's just going to move and it's going to be this awesome revival. And we're all waiting for that day, but I've realized that day, the day is never going to come where God just sovereignly does it all without his church. He works through you and me. He wants to change the world today through you and me. He wants to change situations and families this week and this month through you and me. He wants to change the world through the church. One more quick scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 5, it says, after all, who is Apollos? Who is Paul? Apollos was a man, and Paul was obviously a man. Paul speaking, he says, who is Apollos? Who is Paul? We are only God's servant through whom you believe the good news. Each of us did the work the Lord gave us. I planted the seed in your hearts, and Apollos watered it. But it was God who made it grow. Another version says, but God gave the increase. So Paul said, I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. It's not important who does the planting or who does the watering. What's important is that God makes the seed grow. The one who plants and the one who waters work together for the same purpose, and both will be rewarded for their own hard work. For we are both God's workers, and you are God's field, you are God's building. And so, it really, without that seed and without the water, God doesn't have anything to work with. He relies on me and you to plant seeds, to water seeds, to pray, to encourage, to do all the things necessary. And then, boom, God is the one who gives the increase. God is the one who causes that thing to grow. A lot of believers have a mindset that, well, God will just do it one day. And if God wanted my city to be saved, then he's God, I'm not. He can just go and he can save my city. If God wants to save my neighbor, he's perfectly capable to talk to him. But that's not the way that God moves. God moves through me and you. I'm intimately and intricately knowing and discovering this truth more and more. There's recently been a couple suicides in Sarnia. And I became aware that the Lord had actually spoken to a number of the people at Dunamis Church. He said, go pray for this guy, bring healing, go talk to this guy. And they didn't do it. And I'm not saying that just because they didn't do it that these kids committed suicide, but I am saying the Lord was reaching out. The Lord was trying to reach out through his people. I want to tell you, and it's a hardcore truth, and a lot of times it's too hardcore maybe for some believers to really want to accept, but it's the absolute truth, is that our decisions, either to reach out or not, can either save people or not. And so I want to encourage us today that there's so much riding on your life. There's so much riding on my life. I do these video blogs to encourage people because I felt the Lord tell me to. We've had almost 3,000 views of people being encouraged and challenged and changed by the Word of God. And that's just really the beginning. But imagine that you weren't watching me right now, that you weren't being encouraged right now. I mean, I want to do my part. I encourage you with all my heart to do your part. Let's have an amazing month together. Let's see the kingdom of God brought forth in this city or your respective city. And let's see God have his way in and through our lives. God bless you today. Have an amazing weekend. Have an amazing day. Today's Friday, October 1st. Have an amazing day. Let's get ready for an amazing month. Praise God. Hallelujah. We'll see you again Monday morning.